Hello Eurovision lovers, it's that time of the year again. Okay, so Albania decides its entry, yes, but it's also Christmas time! Happy Christmas to those on the channel who celebrate it, and to mark Christmas 2021, I thought I'd have a look at the songs that have been entered into Eurovision, which I think have a little bit of Christmas to them. Some of them might not necessarily have words that relate to Christmas, but maybe something within their sound, the melody, has really touched me to say, this sounds a bit like Christmas. So let's have a look at the ultimate Christmas Eurovision songs. Okay, so this couldn't be a video dedicated to Christmas songs if we didn't have the most obvious one, Laponia, Lapland from Finland in 1977. And that's Monica there singing for Finland. And what a voice she has, but actually goes into a bit of a screech there. Do you think that perhaps she maybe didn't get the present she wanted? Maybe. But Laponia absolutely is a clap-along, sing-along type of song. And you can't deny that that's not a bad performance at all. Moving on now to Casanova from Andorra in 2008. And if you remember at the start of the video, I said that perhaps the words of these songs may not be Christmassy, but there may be a Christmassy feel to the actual song. And I do think that's the case for the melody. And certainly in the video, when you see all the snow falling in the forest there, and Gisela running through that snowy forest like Little Red Riding Hood. I love this song, and I love the ending of the video because it does look very sort of wintry, and there she is sort of gazing at Casanova. And moving on to Norway with Nocturne, performed by Secret Garden. Now this song is so special and magical, isn't it? It's a little bit, I would say, akin to Walking in the Air. It's got a magical, crystal, Christmassy feel to it. Of course, the song is When the Dark Night Delivers the Day, and certainly one might say that that happens when November turns to December and we get Christmas. Beautiful. Staying with Norway this time, it's the 1980 entry for them. Now this song is a little bit political, and was a political type song, but it talks about Lapland, it talks about the Sami people, and I think the start there that you heard was very Christmas-like, wasn't it? That sort of wintry, blowy, horny kind of feel to it. And of course, they're a bit like Christmas, aren't they? He's certainly dressed for Christmas, isn't he? And you have to admire this song because it really is quite pretty, I would say. Now we're with Israel in 1979 on their winning entry, Hallelujah. Hallelujah, by its very words, is, what can we say? It sounds very Christmassy, Hallelujah. And this song builds and builds and builds and builds with more action musically and vocally as the song progresses. And it's the type of song you could probably hear potentially at a carol, couldn't you? You could just imagine yourself singing this at carols. Well, I could anyway, I think so. So there's Israel and Hallelujah. Now, no Christmas is complete without a party, right? And the Russian singers here, the Russian grannies from 2012, are inviting us to party, and the same as a party for everybody. And if we can't party at Christmas, when can we party? Right, Boris Johnson and the British government, this is a party for everybody. And I would say it's one of those foot-topping, dancey songs that you could just have a drink to, get up, enjoy, and dance around to, and bake, and cook, and eat some cookies, like what they're doing there. Now we're moving on to Nicole and the winning song, Ambition Frieden, a little piece from 1982. And this song itself is a little anthem, a little gesture, and a nod to encouraging peace among nations. And when it comes to Christmas, of course, it's a time when we would think, I suppose, of being peaceful and getting along and taking care of each other and looking out for our neighbours and friends and family, etc. And this is Nicole's song for peace. And yeah, when can we not have peace if it's not a Christmas, right?
Now we're moving on to Den Vilda by One More Time in Sweden in 96. Now I know what you're going to say. You're going to say, Podrick, I have seen a few of your videos and this song is in quite a few of the videos. And you're right. Okay, so I do love the song Den Vilda, but it has that winter sound. We're talking about winter in the Swedish land. It talks about waterfalls. The song itself is very dreamy. And again, a bit like Norway in 1995, it has that sort of winter wonderland feel to it, doesn't it? And it's just so pretty, especially there at the end as well. So pretty indeed. Okay, this is in Spieldus, way, way back in 1963. It talks about a musical box. And the lyrics themselves actually talk about fairies and shepherds. And my goodness, when do we hear about shepherds but at Christmas time, right? So we talk about the shepherds or three wise men. And this song, because it is in Spieldus or a musical box, has that very pretty Christmas sound to it, doesn't it? And yeah, you've got to admire this song for being quite Christmassy. Maybe not so Christmassy, but certainly has a party, maybe Christmas party element to it. Alcohol is free from the Greek guys back in Eurovision 2013. Now, this is certainly a party, happy type of song, isn't it? And I invite you, wherever you're at, to celebrate Christmas if that's what you do, and get up if you're sitting, get up, stand, jump around, get ready for Christmas, and if you're having a drink, have one, and cheers to you from me for Christmas. Now this is the last song here, and it's called Jedan Dan from Yugoslavia in 1968. As you can probably tell, the melody of this song has, I would say, and would suggest, a Christmas sound to it. Of course, Jedan Dan, performed by these two guys, they look like not only are dressed for Eurovision, but they're dressed for Christmas, aren't they? And he's playing the flute there just to prove it, if we didn't already know it. And you've got to admire these two guys are dancing around. It's quite a jolly song. And yeah, we're not saying about those dance moves, but it's a pretty song, Jedan Dan.
So that was my little rundown of what I think to be Christmassy Eurovision songs. What would you have on that list? Would yours be different to mine? Have I missed a really, really important one? Let me know here on the channel, of course. And the most important thing for me to say from me to you, my Eurovision loving friends, is that if you're celebrating Christmas, I hope you enjoy it. I hope you have a special time with the people that matter most to you. And of course, as always, until next time, my Eurovision Christmas loving friends, you take care. Enjoy the conversation, enjoy the debate, love the music, and join in with the Christmas fun! Yay! Ho, ho, ho!